back to my channel. I hope you're all doing well today. This is a makeup tutorial, but I'm not really sure what it's actually going to end up looking like. I have a kind of a rough idea of what I'm aiming for. For foundation, I'm going to use L'Oreal True Match. I have actually been using Infallible quite a lot recently, but I feel like this one just looks a little bit more natural on my skin and it's a little bit lighter. This one's got an awesome coverage, but it is a little bit more noticeable when you're wearing it. The weird thing about my skin at the moment is that even though I've got lots of like deep spots and redness, the actual texture of, the actual texture of my skin is very, very like smooth and probably the best it's been in a long time, which is really weird considering that blemishes are like poof. So I don't know what's going on. I'm going to use that on the Real Techniques multitask brush and of course just start out at my cheeks because I have the most redness there, and then work towards my nose. Next, I'm going to conceal underneath my eyes with NARS Creamy Concealer in Medium Custard. This thing is like completely empty, but I'm not giving up. I'm just going to blend that in with my finger. Next, I'm going to powder with the NARS Pressed Powder in Beach with the Sigma Large Powder F20 brush. I know these products that I'm using aren't exactly new, but the focus is more so on the eyes for this particular tutorial, so I don't really want to go too experimental, I guess, with the face, just because I know what works so well for my skin. And it's these particular products. So I'll save, you know, using all brand new products and things like that for a first impressions video, because I actually can film quite a lot of those. Then, as usual for my eyes, I'm going to use MAC Mineralized Skin Finish Natural in Light with the Sigma Tapered Highlighter F35 brush. For my cheeks, I'm going to use the Rimmel Natural Bronzer in 022 Sun Bronze. I believe this is matte. And I'm going to use that on my NARS ITA brush. I'm going to contour. On my cheeks, I'm going to use the NYC Color Wheel Mosaic Face Powder in Pink Cheek Glow. Now to highlights, I'm going to use MAC Mineralized Skin Finish in Lightscapade. I'm not sure if this is a limited edition product, but I've just recently started using it again, and I absolutely love it. It's like the perfect, just like standard light kind of whitish highlight shade. Love it. This is the Artiste by Manicure Professional Brush, highlighter brush. I've also been obsessed with this recently. It's really, really nice. So I grab a little bit of that on my brush and then just place that on the highest points of my cheeks. Oh, I just love it. I've actually stopped using the Bobbi Brown one because I was getting a lot of little like bumps on my skin around this area here. Just like very, yeah, uneven little weird bumps. And it was just coincidentally placed where I put my highlighter, and I always use the Bobbi Brown one. And now that I'm looking at my skin again, it actually has cleared up. So that must have been the Bobbi Brown product, which is really weird because I've never had like an actual, like a proper reaction from a powder makeup product before. But yeah, it was a good thing because it means that I got to try out this again. Next, I'm going to fill in my brows using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Powder Duo in Medium Brown. So it just looks like this with the MAC 266 brush, my ultimate, all-time favorite eyebrow brush. It is just incredible. Then I like to use the lighter shade to fill in this, the kind of the beginning of my eyebrows. I'm just going to set them in place using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Clear Brow Gel. This isn't a crucial step, but I feel like if you put all that effort into making your brows look amazing and then you don't set them in place, the risk of them fluffing up is high. Okay, so I'm just gonna have a bit of fun here. I'm just gonna experiment. I've got one of my palettes here and all of these eyeshadows here are by Stila, and I would love to use them because I don't really get to use them very often. I don't really reach for them, despite them being like incredible. Like they're so buttery and creamy and so pigmented. So I'm gonna just come up with some kind of a look and just see what happens. I don't know. I might start off using the Stila eyeshadow in Pigalle, I think that's how you pronounce it. It's like a really nice kind of, yeah, plummy shade. And I'm going to use that on the Sigma Tapered Blending E35 brush. So I'm gonna dunk my brush in there and then make sure that I tap off the excess. And then I'm gonna start blending this into my crease. I'm going to just focus that on the outer corner today, I think. This kind of area here, before I get too close to this area here. Then I'm going to use another E35, a clean one, and just blend that out a little bit into the crease just to soften up the eyeshadow. Then I'm going to grab an E25, which is a little bit smaller than the E35, with the Pigalle shade, and blend that a little bit closer towards my nose and blend it up a little bit higher as well. Because at the moment, when I look straight ahead, you can't really properly see it. So I want it to be a little bit higher up towards the eyebrow. So when my eyes look straight ahead, you can actually see. Then I'm going to grab the Zoeva 234 Luxe Smoky Shader Brush. I'm just gonna place this in the outer corner of my eyelid, just plonk it down like that. You really, you know, don't need to be too heavy-handed when you use these Stila shadows because they are incredibly pigmented. So I'm just placing that on the outer corner of my eye and very softly blending that into the crease. All right, so now that we've done the top half of our eyes with that one shade, I'm going to use the same 234 Luxe Smoky Shader Brush with the Pigalle color and tap off the excess. And I'm gonna blend that into the outer kind of half of my lower lash line. So I'm not gonna blend it all the way in just yet. I'm not too sure if I want it to be brought to the very inner corner or if I just want it to be halfway. So we shall see. Then I'm just taking the E25 and I'm blending that very gently. So kind of just blending in a bit of a triangle shape like this shape here. So that we've done the purple, I'm going to go in with a light shade that's very similar to the color of my eyelid, because I actually really like that kind of light and then dark effect. This is the Stila Oasis eyeshadow and I'm going to use that on my finger first. And I'm going to place that just where my skin didn't have any eyeshadow on it. And then underneath the lower lash line. Then I'm going to pack some of that onto the flat side of the brush and pat that on my eyelid. Now the difference between using a brush and using your finger for this particular purpose is that a brush kind of blends it out as you apply it, whereas your finger is great at packing on a lot of color, but it doesn't necessarily blend it out as it's applied. It kind of creates a very stark, kind of blunt line. So a brush is great for, yeah, blending as you go. But I find that it doesn't place as much product on your eyelid as your finger does. So I'm going to use the Makeup Store Darkest Shadow Soft Matte Black Eyeliner on my lower lash line, in like the waterline. I wasn't really sure if I wanted to do this, but I've decided that I want to have a very accentuated kind of inner corner tear duct area because it makes your eyes look very like sexy and feminine and like feline. So I'm going to apply this on the lower lash line and see how I like it. I'm just running that on my upper lash line as well. Then I'm going to use the Ico I Do Liquid Eyeliner, which is just a little felt tip. And I'm just going to draw a little kind of triangle, cat eye look thing in my inner corner area. While I'm at it, I'm also just going to line my upper lash line very, very lightly, because it looks more even when I've got this line a bit in the middle, and then to connect it up on the upper lash line just looks a little bit more seamless. So I'm just going to create a very thin line. Next, I'm going to use the Estee Lauder Sumptuous Infinite Daring Length and Volume Mascara in black. This is amazing, probably one of my new favorite mascaras. It's just amazing at like giving you really long, thick black lashes, and it separates them really nicely as well. So next I'm going to apply my favorite pair of lashes by Red Cherry, number 47s. These are amazing for giving you like long, wispy, spidery long lashes, which is obviously what I always love. I'll be honest, I am incredibly, incredibly tempted to go with a nude lip for this look, because that's what I would normally do if I was wearing this out clubbing or something, but I know that I do nude lips very, very often, so I will go for something a little bit unusual for me. So I'm going to dab off any of the lip balm on my lips, and I'm going to use this dark pencil by Makeup Store. It is called Merlot, and it is, yeah, just a very dark lip line. So there we have the finished look. I'm actually very happy that I chose a kind of dark red matte lip rather than a nude lip, because it kind of transforms the look. It makes it look a little bit more mature and kind of sexy and seductive and more sophisticated, rather than like a typical kind of clubbing look. So good one on my part. But yeah, thank you all so much for watching. I love you guys loads, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.